Creatives, how are you? Welcome back to the Nerd Creative Channel. Fireside Chat, Paint by Numbers, Part 23. Grab yourself a coffee, sit back, relax, and enjoy. So we're going to be working on this pink in this video. Here we go. So there's not really that much to paint in the pink, but it's a new colour. Start filling in this area really. Paint is a good consistency. Yeah, that's actually quite good. Slightly thin, but I can go over with a second part if I need to. It's not going right to the edges. I'll do one more minute. I'm just going to slide this down a bit so you can see what I'm painting. I think I should have this painted finished. Four or five videos, rough estimate. So yeah, we're on video 23. Yeah, I know. Let's get some of this pink moving. Like I said before in a previous video, it's been stylized, so it's not using the colours that it normally would be, which is why I wanted to do this one. The kind of stylized finish is what I wanted to go for. Stray hair on it. I keep moving around. I'm watching some other creative channels, mainly the ones regarding diamond drill painting, which I've just recently discovered, and I've got one that I'm going to do at some point in my videos on my channel, but not yet. I want to get this finished, and then I may go to a different hobby. I won't mention what it is yet, but I know what it's going to be. It's not a paint by numbers. It's a build. That's as much as I'm going to say about it at the moment. It's one that I already started before I created the channel. So I'll show you where I got to, I'll show you all the pieces of it, and then I'll start building the next part. See, this pink's really coming on well. Painting well. Yeah, so I watched some of these diamond drills, and with the paint by numbers as well, I like to get the biggest ones I can get, although my desk won't really accommodate the really big ones. This is quite a squiggly section that we've done before. Kind of moves all the way down here. Hoping it paints over that green mistake. It does. Let's get right in there. Yeah, some of you guys, you creatives out there, you some of your channels, you've created some amazing pieces. Those diamond drill, I think that's what you call them. They're very time consuming. I mean, I've got one that I really want to do. I've actually got a paint by numbers version of it as well, like a smaller section in the same kind of image. Really good. So I'll probably do the paint by numbers version first, and the diamond drill will probably take a very long time to do. So I'll just kind of chip away at it when I get around to it. It's quite a big section. Got a couple of videos to edit and upload to YouTube as well. I think it's video 16 and 17. I mean, if you're here where you are now, you've already watched them. You're watching them in order. I'm thinking about doing a time lapse of the whole thing, from part one to wherever I finish, as a something else. For those that don't want to sit through the whole thing, the fireside chats, I'm going to do a time lapse version, which would be interesting. So there'll be no audio. I'll probably do an intro at the start, maybe. Maybe not, I don't know. So let's get in there. So we need to go to the edges. A little difficult because the paint is quite thick. But yeah, we are coming to the end of this. By numbers. Yeah, it's a little thick now. I think I'll have a tiny amount of water into it. To one side. Just want to get a better consistency. Let's get it mixing. Just kind of chop it up a bit. That's better. Better consistency to work with. Right, get the brush on again. Oh yeah, that's much better. Let's see how I can tackle these. Yeah, that's painting much better. So many creatives out there. I mean, I'm new to this on YouTube, so I don't have a lot of content. It's going to take me time to build up a lot of different creative disciplines. So yeah, at the moment we've just got the this paint by numbers. But as I say, I'm going to do something different. Like I said before, this isn't a paint by numbers channel. Some people have a paint by numbers channel. This is not one. It will have a mixture of all kinds of things. So narrow. Video. That's my hand. See where it's gone over with the green? I can cover that up now with the pink. Maybe a second coat will cover it completely. See that we're coming to the end of this now. Which is great. It's Saturday today, but it's not, it's Friday. I'm really not trying to wish my days away. I'm actually glad it's Friday and not Saturday. jaggedy shape. Coverage of this pink is really good. Very opaque. I think there's another pink, a lighter pink, that kind of goes near or beside this pink to create like a blending effect. Up against the yellow and the orange. I can actually clean up some of the areas where I went outside of the line. Putting up against the black now. Sealing in that area. of mist here. Big area down there, but I think I might need to go over it with white because it's navy blue, and I just need to cover this section here with white because I don't think the pink cover that blue. Should have actually done this before I started because that paint's not going to be dry now. There's a bit more as well here. But we can, there's still areas of white, sorry, the pink that I can still do. A couple of other areas. I can always go around. Go around that bit that I just painted white and leave it until it's dry. So I should really start down here. I'm going to start here. Up nicely against the black. Very nice. Starting to take shape now. Might have to do a second coat because the number 9 is showing through. Don't know if you can see that on camera. So I started watching the pilot episode of Enterprise, Star Trek Enterprise. Yeah. First episode is called Broken Bow. I've just kind of just started it, so it's on the rewatch because I have watched it before, the whole series. So there are going to be spoilers, so if you haven't seen it and you may feel like you do want to see it at some point, if you want to skip past this section. And so there is a Klingon in the first episode, and there are Vulcans. There is a Denobian doctor who actually becomes part of the crew. He's called Dr. Phlox. And Captain Archer's played by Scott Bakula from Quantum Leap. I did mention that in my early video, the whole story of how he was approached and how he signed on board the project and what appealed to him. Long story short, being offered the role of the first captain of the Enterprise, that was his on board, that brought him to sign on to the project. And I did make a slight error when I said Captain Kirk was the first captain of the Enterprise. Originally, he wasn't. It was Captain Pike. Although Captain Pike, like the real saga of Captain Pike, is the actor only starred in the original pilot, but in the canon of Star Trek, they've actually turned that into, he was captain for many years, maybe 10 years. But the thing is, because he started in the pilot back in the 60s, we don't actually know how long he was captain for before Kirk took over. So I suppose you could make a fully fledged character out of Captain Pike, and they've done it several times. They did it with Star Trek 2009. Pike was a thing, and they've done it with Star Trek Strange New Worlds, because this show is a Captain Pike show, although we know his time is limited because of what has happened to him. They actually brought Pike back in the original series. I do know he was in a wheelchair, and he was afflicted by some kind of something, some kind of radiation poisoning or something like that there. But I do believe it wasn't the same actor under the makeup, because the other actor didn't want any part of Star Trek. He did the pilot, and then he was like, nah, this is not for me. So then they hired William Shatner. And the rest of that saga is history. I wonder if the guy who turned down Star Trek after doing the pilot, like Denise Crosby, actually regretted their decision. Because I don't recall seeing this guy. I don't even know what you call him. There we go. I don't even know what you call him. Tells you all I need to know about his career. He may have gone on to do other things that I've never seen, but I don't know who he is. So, but William Shatner, we all know who William Shatner is. Those Star Trek fans. Switch up brushes just for this section, and just to get a big section painted all at once. Try and see where my bigger blue brush is. Did I drop it on the floor? I don't see my bigger blue brush. Well, I think I threw it because I think it was dead. I think it's finished, so I've got this one. So we can do a bulk of this pink with this brush, and then go back and do the edges it just requires me to do less brush strokes to do the coverage. Any time saving options that I have, I will adopt. That's all the nines. I really do think that's all the nines. I can't see any more. It's easier to see where I haven't done now because there's not many places that I haven't done. So I'm going to rinse off this bigger brush. So I can still use it again. But the big blue one that came with the kit, I can't really use it anymore. So I had to throw it because all the bristles of the brushes all stuck together. But like I said, I've got my own brushes, and if I need to purchase some more of these thicker ones, I will do. But I may not need to now because we're coming up to the end of this, and when I do another one I will get brand new brushes in the kit. As long as I wash the brushes out regularly, I should be okay. Canvas parts are slowly disappearing for good, which is really great. I like to see. I can really see it taking shape now. May have to go over with a second coat because it's a little thin. Actually thin before I poured it down as well, so I could do a second coat of it off camera and then come back and ink it to see how good the pink looks. Yeah, so I'm happy I've started Enterprise again. It probably won't take me that long if I don't pause and watch something else. Won't take me that long to watch the whole series because it is like only four seasons, but like the last two seasons are the best, which is always the case. The later seasons are always better than the earlier ones, but I mean overall as a show it really works. There was the time war situation going on. Third season there was the Zindi, that alien of races, that insectoid I think they were. They explained why Klingons looked human in the original series and why Worf doesn't look human. And Dr. Soong is in there, Dr. Noonien Soong is in there. He's quite young in there and he's played by Brent Spiner, obviously, because Dr. Soong looks like Data, because Dr. Soong modelled the look of Data on himself when he he was younger. So it was good to see. And I think René, here we go, René Aubenjois, something like that. He's in it as well, but he's not playing. Oh, I think I've messed that bit up. I don't know what colour that is, because there's no number on it. There's a 7 there, but that doesn't have a number on it, so I don't know why. Maybe it's supposed to be black. I don't know. I'll have to check the reference to see what it's supposed to be. I'm going to spin it. You know I'm going to spin it. Shaking a little bit now because I know how delicate that corner is. So I'll take this bit here. It's just about sharpening it up, finishing it. Up against the navy. It's very thin though, very thin. I think a second coat is definitely in order off camera. Because it's nice to put on video of me colouring these colours, but I don't really want to do a second coat on camera because I think it's, because once you've seen me do one area, I don't think it's really that interesting to watch me paint a second coat on the area. So I'll do all that off camera, and when I come back we'll go into the next pink section. I think I've got enough time left in this video to finish this pink. Enterprise for quite a while. I would say it could possibly be 10 years or more since I watched Enterprise all the way through. Like I say, it's my kind of least favourite but less watched, less undiscovered country, you might say, that I haven't watched a lot of it. I kind of watched it, I think I watched the whole series twice. Where Deep Space Nine, I've probably watched the whole series about 5 or 6 times. And that tells you all you need to know on what Star Trek I really like and what Star Trek I kind of like. Tell me what Star Trek series you like. If there's a particular series, it could be Next Generation and Voyager, because they're quite similar. They're Monster of the Week, episodic, sailing around in a ship, flying around in a ship every week. You might like Discovery. You might like Strange New Worlds. You might like the original series. Let me know which Star Trek do you like, or do you like them all, or do you just like the films? Because it's a huge franchise. There is a lot to choose from. This might be quite tricky. I'm actually off camera. Apologies. I'm doing right at the edge. I'm just going to do it quickly as I can. Get this bit done. It's right at the bottom. Might be able to slide this up a bit. Yeah, you can see what I'm doing. This way I can get the complete bottom edge. I think I've printed my hand on there now. There's a pink bit there that I need to cover. I'll do all that off camera, get it all cleaned up, ready for the next colour. So we'll just get this section done, the bottom edge. Squeeze my hand right around this side and just get this bit done. I just need to do a couple of bits there. Let me just tidy some of this pink up, because it is very, very thin. It just kind of just a thicker amount, just to, so it's not see-through, because I can still see the number 9, even though I've done a second coating over it. So we just, I mean, this is for me personally. I am a bit of a perfectionist when it comes to this sort of stuff. I mean, I'll probably spend a long time doing a second coat over the whole thing off camera, but that's just me. I'm very like that. If I'm not happy with it, I'll just keep going and going and going until it looks pretty much the way I want it to look. But this pink is very thin. Not sure why. Like, it was thin before I watered it down. Maybe it is a little bit transparent rather than opaque. So yeah, that's looking quite good. Let me just go over a bit of this, because it kind of, you probably can't see on camera how transparent it is, but it is very transparent and it's kind of bugging me. So I just want to clean it up a little bit as quickly as possible. I don't want to really do it all on camera, because I think it's boring if I'm painting over what I've just painted. You just watch me painting. So I'm just going to quickly go over it, because I'm going to go over it with a fine tooth comb at the end, and I'm going to go over all the colours so that they're evenly coated, because that would really bug me. I mean, it's, most people wouldn't really care, but I do, because every time I see it on the wall, it would really bug me, where I can see the transparent and the uneven distribution of paint. I think I'll finish this bit down at the bottom, and just checking now, see if there's any more of these pinks. Just checking. No, I think we've got them all covered. So what I need to do is I need to spin it again, just to finish these last couple of areas, which are here. Let's get them finished. Let's get the pink pen back on. It's very vibrant pink, this. The other pink is more like a, not a flesh coloured pink, but you know, in cartoon and comics, it would be like what flesh colour is in the animated kind of world. Like a flesh pink, but like in reality, it's nothing like the colour of flesh or skin. Okay, let's get this bit finished and then we're done. We're done with the pink. I will go over it again off camera and evenly distribute the paint across. Let me see if I spin it again. I may be slightly off camera for this angle, but I do apologise, because I'm just trying to get this bottom edge on this section finished. And once that's done, I can leave that to dry. It'll be the end of this video. It'll be video 23 done. Longer format, which I'm happy to do the longer 1 hour formats, because it kind of works, because I can get a lot done in one video. Let me just get that tiny corner. Where else did I miss? I can spin it around again. Let me just fill this. I'm going to slightly go over this again, because I'm not happy with the transparency of it. So I'm just going to quickly kind of tighten up that edge as well. I just want to make it a bit more opaque, because parts of it are opaque, but a vast majority of it is quite transparent and it's not looking great. It looks kind of rushed and cheaply done, but you can make it look more professional if you add a second coat. That's in my opinion. A lot of people are not interested in doing a second coat of kind of making it look a little bit more professional when it's finished. Sometimes you don't have to do a second coat to make it look great, sometimes you do. I'm finding that I have to with some of the colours. Even some of the darker colours, like the dark blues, I've had to do like a second and third to make it an even finish all the way across it. Black is easy, I don't really need to. There are parts on the black where it's not quite gone on the canvas. It's kind of hit and missed, and there's been tiny little pinpricks, circles of white canvas showing through, but yeah, overall it's pretty evenly distributed, which is the kind of finish that I want. as I say, I will be going over it up at the very end, and I'll be running around with different colours just to make the paint even. And I think it will make the overall finish of it look better. I'm going to use stretching bars to mount this. I'm not going to put it in a glass frame. I want to keep it in its canvas format. I'm going to see if the next one I do, if I can stretch it on canvas, on stretching bars, before I start it. That would be quite fun. Although I don't know if that, I don't know if it would sag because of the liquid of the paint and then the heaviness of the paint. So I'm not sure if I should mount it afterwards, which I'm going to do with this one. I've got a fold all the way down the middle there and down there, which I'm not happy about. But once you start painting it, you can't iron it. So the next one I'll do, I'm going to iron it, because a lot of the ones I've been receiving have been folded rather than rolled up, which is kind of disappointing. But I've watched a few YouTube videos, and they do suggest that you iron them with a tea towel on them. So I will iron the next one before I do it, because the crease will not go away. It might lessen when I stretch it over the stretching what are they called? Panels? No, not panels. Stretching I can't remember, there's a name for them, but I don't know what they are. Stretching, there's a weird name for them that I've never heard of. So I've never heard of like a square canvas that comes in separate pieces that you just slot together. That's kind of new for me. I haven't got my phone near me, so I can't really Google. I like sticks, I like canvas sticks or whatever they call them, that you kind of put one there and you put one there and then you slot them together. You don't need glue or anything like that there. So I would measure here and here, here, here. I would buy the ones, two of these, top and bottom, and then two either side, slot them together, and then I would turn the canvas down, place it down. I might actually stretch it, show you me stretching it on camera. But yeah, I think we've done all the pinks now, so close that. This is the end of video 23. Let's give that brush a good cleaning. So we'll put the brush there, and we'll get paint 7, which is the lighter pink. As you can see, I don't know if you can see, because it's quite bright. So it's a very light pink, so we'll sit that there. 7, just it's a bit of a glare. So that's where we'll finish, and we will continue in the next video. And I would like to thank you for your company. As you can see, we are nearly done on this. I'm really impressed. So I'd like to thank you for your company once again, and I will see you in the next video.